Greetings, hello, and welcome back to some more Longo of the Chosen Class guides. And today we're going to take a look at the Reaper. Now, to say it out first, the Reaper received the most recent changes, up to a point where I actually haven't played at all with the most recent version of it. So, all of that with a good grain of salt. I do have some experiences with most of the builds though, and I'm gonna try to approach it from a pretty open mindset here. Now let's talk about the base kit first. The Reaper gains Shadow, which is an advanced form of concealment similar to what you're used to from the base game, but there's some important differences. First of all, at the start of the mission, if you start with concealment, the Reaper has concealment active, not Shadow. So if your squad loses concealment because someone runs into a drone or because you start shooting enemies, the Reaper will also be revealed. You also cannot activate Shadow while in concealment. That's kind of important to note, because if you like scout with them ahead because you think they have Shadow, they are safe, they're not. They also will not have the reduced detection range of Shadow, they have the normal concealment detection range at the start of the mission. Right, then they get tracking, which works a little bit different than what you might know from the base game, where all enemies you see stay tracked for the rest of mission. No, it just extends your detection range to a little bit outside of visual range. So visual range is 17 tiles in the game, and I'm fairly certain tracking detects enemies up to 20 tiles away, so like very slightly out of visual range. Now it doesn't specify to the 20, and I'm not 100% certain that it's 20, or maybe it's just 19. Like don't sue me for it if it's not exactly 20. So what will happen is you enemy detected units will appear as a visual outline, and they stay detected until the end of the player's turn. So even if you move away until the end of a turn, the enemies still remain there, and you kind of can, based on that, judge a little bit where you can move to safely without activating them. Now there is a little bit of an issue where if you just have the tracking outline on the map, I don't think the target preview in the game will probably show it to you that you gain line of sight to them. So I think with Gotcha again though, you should see when you actually gain line of sight. And finally, you start with squad side. So all your dreams of actually playing a snapshot sniper can finally come true. You have someone who can move and shoot from squad side and then miss because of the massive aim penalty. But anyway, you can work with that. So that being said, let's look at the first builds, and I'm going to start with the one that I'm most familiar with, which is the Knife Reaper. Well, I haven't mentioned it yet, but the Claymore that the Reaper got in the base game has been replaced with a throwing knife as a secondary weapon, and there's a build completely focused around this knife, pretty much, which is creatively named the knife build here. So, what is this all about? It's mostly everything that you find in the middle row, but with a few caveats throwing in by me here. Starting it off, Knife Juggler gives you +1 damage and 1 additional throwing knife. It also allows you to replenish your knives if you get kills with your primary weapon. Now that seems like a very essential perk to pick up on the knife build. I did, however, throw a blue box around Blood Trail. Instead of the +1 damage you get here, you get +2 damage as long as you shoot a target that has already been wounded this turn, and you also reduce the target's dodge by -40. The reason I point that specifically out is because there are very few skills that reduce enemies' dodge, and especially if you fight the Chosen, most of them come with the Infighter perk, reducing gaining 40 dodge, how coincidentally, when you're within a few tiles of them. So I'm starting to think that dodge reduction might be super useful in combination with rangers that want to use both barrels as the highest damage attack and go in and point blank and pop the chosen in the face, right? And this is one of the few skills that gives you dodge reduction. That being said, what I mentioned already in a Templar video, basing your whole build around fighting the chosen, which you only do on a handful of missions during the campaign, might not be the best. So kind of if you go for the blood trail instead of knife juggler route, then I would say your Reaper will become fairly useless in any longer missions because they cannot replenish their knives. Well, if you go for a knife build, right? Yeah, and that's gonna hurt. That's gonna hurt a lot. So keep in mind what you want to use your Reaper for when you make that choice. Moving on. Crippling Strike. A knife throw that leaves the target at one mobility, at zero mobility rather, maimed. So this is really strong, obviously, against all melee enemies, because if they can't move, they can't hurt you. I'm thinking about Berserkers, Chrysalids, Berserker Queen to a certain extent. So really, really good utility. Also just really nice to maybe cripple a unit that's outside of vision of the rest of your squad. Keep in mind, I'm not sure if I mentioned it yet, all knife attacks do not break your shadow concealment. So if you use it from shadow, you will not be revealed. Doesn't matter if you kill the enemy or not, knife attacks do not reveal you. Talking about things that don't reveal you, Silent Killer guarantees that the Reaper stays in shadow with killing shots. Now, since I just mentioned, knife throws do not reveal you anyway, so this is obviously for your rifle shots. So if you use the knife build and you want to replenish your knives with some rifle kills here, primary weapon kills, then you can do that from shadow and Silent Killer will not reveal you. That being said, the observant viewer might have noticed that the red square is around Ghost Grenade. That's pretty much a personal preference, because I value concealment and stealth a whole lot, and being able to reconceal a friendly unit during a mission seems really strong. Now, if the Reaper themselves is on a mission, you do have a scout that can scout ahead with shadow. You don't necessarily need a second unit that has concealment for scouting purposes. But then again, shadow has a cooldown, it has a limited duration. Having a concealed unit might be strong. It can also be used actually as a defensive action. Let's say your shinobi rushes forward, slashes a big enemy, and activates another group. You can ghost grenade them to get them concealment, as long as they're obviously not flanked and getting immediately revealed again. So lots of nice uses. Final use outside of defensively and scouting is an offensive use. Whenever you have a unit with Shadow Strike in your squad, most importantly, my most favorite combo, Shadow Strike Saturation Fire, they do that once, wipe out a whole group, you give them a ghost grenade, and then just do it all again. So, lots of fun to be had with ghost grenades, and that's my, this is my first pick here for this row. Moving on. Staff Sergeant row is a little bit of an awkward row. Blue screen knives, two armor piercing is okay. You disorient your Batek enemies. I kinda wish this would also reduce hack defense, like its counterparts, like blue screen bombs. But then again, I think they didn't want to introduce another source of hack reduction. So at the end of the day, you get two armor pierce, which is okay, especially late game once you run into shield bearers, late game purifiers, etc. And considering you don't get the effects of your ammo on your knives, so you can't just run around with AP ammo all the time, it's a good pickup. It doesn't excite me, and I think for Staff Sergeant it could be a little bit stronger. The problem in this row is the alternatives aren't really there. Cheap Shot is kind of reliant on your primary weapon. It needs to be an enemy that has been damaged this turn, and it only then gives you a movement action. It feels, this seems a really weak-ish perk, I think. I need to double check it later in the video. I think there's like Momentum. There's an XCOM row perk which does the same thing with less restrictions, so that feels also kind of weak. And of course rapid deployment, if you're not going for the grenade stuff, that's probably a dead pick. So you're stuck with blue screen knives. Deal with it. Now, Tech Sergeant Drew, knife encounters. Also, as I like to call it, knife to meet you, allows you basically to throw two knives as a target as long as you attack them from within five tiles. So it's kind of like close encounters, which assaults get with their shotgun to really kind of double your damage output there. So really strong, especially if you're going for Rent the Marked. You can apply 100% crit chance buff or debuff onto an enemy, which allows for some very, very interesting combinations and critting of enemies that you don't normally expect to crit. The alternative here is Death Dealer. You get a flat out 25% crit chance on all your attacks, and if you crit against a flank target, you deal double critical damage. Now, here's one of the things where I've never played with this perk, and I'm not 100% sure, and I really would like you to look at the comments for people either correcting me or confirming. I assume here that critical shots includes knife attacks, not just shots with your primary weapon, but all critical attacks, critical hits, deal double critical damage. The other part, what I'm going to assume here, when it says double critical damage, it means on a critical hit, your total damage will be doubled. Similar to how it works for Killer Instinct on the Assault, for Precision Shot on the Sniper. That it's not just the small portion of critical damage that it's doubled, but rather on a critical hit, your whole damage is doubled. Which makes this an exceptionally strong perk. I still think the flexibility of knife encounters and being able to attack two different targets is really nice, but certainly a way kind of to keep out an eye for Death Dealer, because it can do pretty good damage, especially I think with later tier knives that have a good crit chance. Moving on. Gunnery Sergeant, for the knife build, Impersonal Edge. When you get a kill with throwing knife, reduce the shadow cooldown by one, and you get a stackable 20 aim buff for 3 turns. The aim buff is nice to have, feels like a little bit late for that at Gunnery Sergeant. It's like you probably know how to use your knife to get 100% knife throws. Reducing the shadow cooldown effectively makes you have shadow up all the time. Of course, shadow will still drop and you have to recast it, so there is a chance to activate enemy groups when it drops off at the start of your turn. But being able to instantly enter shadow again, as long as you got 2 kills while you were in shadow previously, seems really strong. So that's my primary pick here, and I don't think any of the others are a good alternative here. Finally, Rent the Mark. So as I just said, throwing knives, any attack with your throwing knives, apply a 50% crit chance debuff on the target. So for stuff like gatekeepers, sectopods, throw a knife at them, suddenly everybody is critting. Throw two knives at them, and you kind of guarantee that everybody is critting. Now, what I did with that skill in one of my episodes is stacked it so high on the chosen warlock, hunter, I don't even remember which one it was anymore, to crit the chosen. So chosen have a minus 200 crit chance debuff, but you can use Rent the Mark to overcome that and crit them. I wouldn't advise it necessarily, because at the end of the day, it's that takes a lot of setup and might not be worth all the effort you put in it, but it's very satisfying to see a crit on the chosen. There is an alternative though, since it's kind of a niche use. Often you're finishing off targets with your knives and you don't need that crit chance increase. So maybe you're better off with homing mines. So this is the good old claymore from the base game coming back with the homing mine perk. You throw it at an enemy, whenever that enemy takes damage, the homing mine explodes. You have baked in the shrapnel upgrades, so they do 8 damage, have a radius of 2 tiles. And I think you have 4 charges with that, so that's really solid and allows you to, you know, contribute a little bit of extra explosive damage, shredding, and AoE, which you lack otherwise. So yeah, that's what I would go for the knife build. Let's have a look at the sniper build next. Take a look at the rifle build then. A few of the talents were already discussed briefly when looking at the knife build, but we're gonna come back to them shortly here. One thing to maybe point out, the vector rifle, the primary weapon of the Reaper, gives 10 additional aim. That makes him very accurate and combines also with some of the other perks. So let's start off. Of course, Blood Trail, plus 2 damage if the target has been wounded this turn. It's important maybe to point out again, so the wound has to have happened this turn. So it's not just on any wounded target, but if someone else shot the target, then you can finish them off with +2 damage to your attack. This is also, again, it applies to any attacks you deal, so also your knife attacks, but also your pistol attacks, if you wanna train your Reaper with pistol skills. And there are a few things that combine fairly nicely with pistols. Next up here, Shooting Sharp. Ranged attacks, which again is all your ranged attacks, gain 2 armor piercing and 15 aim against units in cover. Now, I don't think I've ever found out if it's 2 armor piercing all the time and 15 aim against units in cover, or if it's 2 armor piercing and 15 aim if the unit's in cover. So if anyone has the answer to that, please help me out in the comments below. It's kind of, I'm not a huge fan of the perk because I don't want to shoot units in cover. I want to use my shadow to get flanks and take flanking shots. That being said, sometimes you just have to shoot someone in cover, and with the 15 aim from here and the 10 additional aim from your rifle, you can actually do that fairly effectively. You might be tempted to pick up Crippling Strike for the utility of the maim debuff, of being able to neutralize any mobility, but I think if you're going for a dedicated rifle build, this is the better option, because you might actually not be upgrading your knives at all and only spending money on your rifle. Now, Sergeant Row, a very colorful row. I still think, for all the reasons mentioned before, that Ghost Grenade is the strongest pick here, but if you're on a rifle build, then I think Silent Killer might enable you to just take more shots all the time, because you know, not gonna be dropping shadow. But with good positioning, like, you wanna be shooting targets that are already engaged, right? so that have previously been damaged. So whether or not you remain in shadow isn't really that a big deal, right? If you drop shadow because you don't have Silent Killer, that's fine because they were all, the enemy was already in range of the other guys because they were damaged by someone this turn. So as long as you're in a safe position to drop shadow, I don't see any problem with that. That's why I don't think Shadow Killer is all that big of a deal. I think it's really more appropriate for the knife builds, so you can silently stack up your knife charges. Serial takes a lot of setup. It is nice to clean up a bunch of low health enemies, but then again, a lot of other classes have abilities to clean up low health enemies. So maybe not the top choice. Again, it's just a matter of Ghost Grenade is a Master Sergeant perk for Grenadier. Like, that's how strong it is. And being able to pick that up at Sergeant rank, it's just so good. Staff Sergeant, I'd say Sheepshot is the only viable pick here for a rifle build. Again, keep in mind, it needs to be an enemy that has been damaged this turn. It's so similar to Blood Trail. And you only get a movement action for that, and it has to be a standard shot with your rifle. So not like a banished shot. Or if you have special abilities like Chain Shot or Dead Eye that you pick up in the XCOM roll, they will not trigger Cheap Shot. Needs to be a standard shot with your rifle. So kind of very restrictive. Also, the momentum thing I mentioned, it's Reapers don't get that. So no, there's no alternative to this if you want movement actions. Unless, we'll see if we can pick up Implacable at T4 XCOM roll perk. I don't have all of them memorized. But yeah, it's kind of, the other choices are bad too, so might as well pick this up. Tech Sergeant, I think Death Dealer is the clear winner, especially if you have abilities that allow you to reach 100% crit chance. So you get 25% from Death Dealer, you get 40% if you're flanking the enemy, that's 65. You can pack Talon rounds, that's another 10 for 75. Laser sight is another 10, 85. If you have something like open fire here, suddenly you're at 95 crit chance, that's pretty good. Alternatively, for more stationary builds, steady hands gives crit chance, and there are a bunch of other XCOM row abilities that can provide you with some crit chance. So if you can reach 100% crit, Death Dealer is a reliable, huge damage increase. Banish is nice to take out a single target. Keep in mind though, it works slightly or massively different than in the base game, as in each shot gives a 15 aim penalty that stacks up. So minus 15, minus 30, 45, 60. At that point, you're just missing. So it might be nice or seem nice to take out a big target. I just think the gunner with cyclic fire standing behind you is the better person to take out that big target, and you would rather pick off two or three small targets with Death Dealer and light him up, for example. Very straightforward skill, we all know it from the Ranger class. Take two shots, or rather, your shots are no longer turn ending, only cost you a single action, giving you some additional utility to do something else with your second action. Now, if you combine Light 'em Up with the Master Sergeant perk here, Death from Above, and you actually manage to be on the high ground, you can easily take three shots a turn. One with Light 'em Up, then shoot someone else to get a kill shot from the high ground, for Death from Above to proc, and then get in a third shot. And that's potentially more damage than you could have had with Banish anyway in the first place. The big downside is Reapers cannot get any grappling suits. So they have their standard Reaper armor, so no grappling options. So consistently getting the high ground will require a little bit more planning, a little bit more effort than other classes that can just grapple to some high ground position. The alternative, once again, homing mine, I think is a strong perk. Being able to just throw 2-3 mines at a group of enemies and then have your grenadier blow them all up is always fun, right? Blowing up enemies with mines sounds like a good time, unless you're the guy on the receiving end of the mines. Alright, enough about the Rife build. Let's have a quick look at what's happening here with Total Combat and grenade perks. So apparently there's a grenadier build for the Reaper, and to expand a little bit on that, in one of the previous builds of the game there was actually a perk here called Shadow Grenadier, which allowed you to throw your grenades without losing concealment. That stuff was broken and probably made the grenadier tree the strongest Reaper tree that was in the game at that point. It was promptly removed, and so the grenadier spec line is kinda what's left after that, and it feels a little bit awkward. I still think it might be viable, but I also think it depends a lot on your XCOM role perks to really give you a purpose, a meaning in life. And that could be something like we see here with Combat Engineer, being able to pick that up early and getting some grenades that actually destroy cover and supporting your squad in that way. Or if you have CDG, Coup de Grace, that where you get additional aim and crit against disoriented enemies, you use basically rapid deployment and your flashbang grenades to disorient the enemies for your own shots and then deliver massive damage with Death Dealer. But getting ahead of myself. Total Combat. I think that's the exactly same perk that Skirmishers got, and we talked about this in that episode. It's grenade perk on crack. No cooldown. Longer throwing range and increased radius for your grenades. So that's really good. Also gives you a grenade only slot, so you have some additional inventory space. So lots of grenade perks. It's kind of missing, the tree is missing like any further upgrades to grenades outside of Packmaster, where you get one additional charge per item. Biggest booms would have been nice, I think, but that's probably just my preference here. And then out of this grenade build, we come here and see Paramedic. Gives you a free medkit, which is great, but then equipped medkits have additional charges. You can use medkit for free reaction, heal additional hit points. That's all nice, but I still think if I'm gonna go for a grenade build, I don't want to literally waste inventory slots on carrying medkit around. I'm gonna try to either be one or the other, but not, you can't be like jack of all trades, master of none. So I would prefer then to just pick up Crippling Strike for the utility you get from that. Sergeant pick Ghost Grenade for all the reasons we mentioned before. Rapid deployment, well, if you're going for some sort of grenade build and you're using utility grenades, then that is a solid pick. If I were to build with this choice of XCOM perks a Grenadier Reaper, I would probably not pick rapid deployment because, hey, if I have Combat Engineer, I'm gonna fill my inventory with frag grenades for terrain destruction and probably not pick up any flashbang or any kind of support grenades. So might just then pick up something else. Be cheap shot. I know that it gets a little bit awkward if you're not carrying around any support grenades whatsoever. So yeah, again, it's I think the Grenadier line depends a lot of what XCOM perks you get, but more on that when we take a look at the available perks there. Death Dealer, ideal situation is CDG and your own flashbangs to trigger additional crit chance to get Death Dealer going. It just still, even for other Grenadier builds, I think it beats the alternatives because you just don't have the skills to support these two picks, and Death Dealer is just a solid increased crit chance and more damage on critical hits. Everybody can crit, right? Even without any other perks supporting it on a flank, you end up with 65% crit and increased damage then from Death Dealer. So that seems really solid. If we're going for grenades, one additional charge for each grenade we carry seems really good. Packmaster, just pack your bags well. It also, you know, if you really go in the paramedic rule and you want to pick up three medkits in your inventory, you get additional charges on them. Now, if you really need four charges for each of your medkits that you carry, I don't know, you might have other problems. And finally, of course, homing mine, just for even more explosions, etc. I have still here a secondary pick on Death from Above, because if you have something like the, what I mentioned before, flashbang supported Death Dealer approach, then maybe you can just kill two people a turn with Death from Above. It might be an option there. Even though I don't have a rating for this yet, I think a Grenadier spec, again, depending on what sort of grenades you're going for, can also then work as an officer. But I think at that point you're trying to fill too many shoes once again. Like, you're trying to be a Grenadier, you can perform a little bit of healing, your base role of tracking and scouting with Shadow is still there, and you want to be an officer at the same time. That might be too many roles to fill at the same time. Alright, so kind of that's the Grenadier approach. Again, it's very much dependent on the XCOM role. If the XCOM role really throws the right perks at you, then I think it's worth considering. Otherwise, for your standard Reaper, I would say pick rifle. If you have high aim, low-ish mobility, pick knives. If you have high mobility and not so high aim, well, even if you have high aim, just drive. I think knife needs a little bit more mobility, rifle spec needs a little bit more aim. That's my take on the whole thing. Equipment wise, it's not much, not many surprises. Of course, you have your special Reaper armor, so you want the best possible there. You have your special Reaper rifle, that's not much choice to be had. I think usually you go with weapon attachments for laser sight for your crits with Death Dealer especially. I don't necessarily think you need aim. Then magazine or loader is always personal preference. I think you have enough action economy that you can probably go with a magazine and get some free actions somewhere to fit your reloads in. And then whatever else suits your fancy. There are some builds, depending on XCOM role perks, where a head trigger might be useful for some Overwatch shots. Otherwise, if you're shooting and you have a stationary build, stock to steady your weapon might not be the worst. Or just go for a suppressor to reduce your infiltration time. PCS, depending on your build, could be something like Death Perception. Most likely, best benefit you get from mobility PCS. because you really want to go the turns when you activate Shadow and go for scouting. You want to cover as much ground as possible, so high mobility just wins in that regard. And yeah, that's this. Let's have a quick look into the wiki and into the XCOM reports. Right, as usual, we're gonna take a look at all the various tier 4 perks first, because this is the expensive stuff where you spend your money on. But as I mentioned before, a lot of the other perk choices might influence your skill tree selections, even to a point of, do I go for a completely different row of skills? So I wanna point those out too. But starting with the tier 4 perks, Apex Predator, criticals with primary weapon, chance to panic the target and nearby enemies. Sounds amazing. Nearby enemies is enemies within 4 tiles, so that's already limiting it a lot. It's a chance to panic, which you don't really have influence on how high the chance is. Generally, I find Apex Predator is not worth the pickup, not worth the 40 points. In a lucky situation, let's say you snipe one target in an unactivated group of enemies and all the others panic, it feels great to have. But then I've had situations where I snipe someone in a rainbow pod of 8 enemies and nobody panics, even though 7 other targets were in range, and it just feels like a waste of 40 points. It doesn't feel strong enough to justify being tier 4, in my opinion. And then again, it's just anecdotal evidence at this point, so I'm not sure. Maybe others were just owning the map thanks to Apex Predator. I've not seen it yet. I wouldn't pick it up for 40, unless I have too many points to spend. Chain shot. Obviously with your primary weapon, so it's more for the rifle build. Gives you a solid damage boost, especially let's say you go for the whole light em up, death from above. So you can then shoot with light em up, shoot again, get death from above, and then chain shot. So getting effectively four shots out seems really strong pickup for that spec. Obviously kind of useless for Grenadier or Knife Spec. Well, not kind of useless, but still too situational to justify 40 AP, I would say. Implacable, great additional mobility. When you get a kill, get a bonus move. So as I said, I think it's kind of, well, you need to get a kill here, but I still think it's better than Cheap Shot, because it doesn't have the other restrictions. So that's nice to have. Again, is it 40 AP nice? Depends on what your avoid perk picks are, but it's really good. Lethal, 2 additional damage with your primal weapon. So I'd say for rifle reapers, that's an automatic pickup. Always nice to have. Obviously for a knife build, not necessarily so great. Run gun is good. I'm not sure if it's really 40 AP good for Reaper, but it's again, it's a nice to have skill. Keep in mind, it's not like an XCOM 1 where you have to run and actually shoot, but you can run and hunker down, run and shadow, run it. It just gives you an extra action, non-movement action at the end of your turn. So super flexibility. Yeah, just really good perk. Rupture, 50 additional critical hit chance on your shot, plus you rupture the target, especially if you're going for the Death Dealer, any of the Death Dealer builds. That's a strong ability to have. I also think every squad late game should have at least one person with Rupture out there. Usually that's gonna be your Ranger or your Gunner bringing that. If for some reason your Ranger or Gunner builds do not have Rupture, then picking it up on your Reaper is a solid choice. That being said, your Reaper kinda wants to take the killing shots on things, right? For all the perks that they have that rely on kills. So Rupture is more like the opening shot. That's why it's probably better suited on another class. But if you need it, and you have it here, it's worth considering for pickup. Alright, so what else do we have here? I'm not going to comment too much on defensive abilities. I think with considering you have Shadow and how you play your cards, I think most of the defensive ones are probably wasted a lot of the time. One, the big exception always being Untouchable. Untouchable is really in your hands to use it, kind of to bait a shot with Untouchable, to make enemies waste an action. So I think that's pretty much always worth a pickup. Shredder, as I said before, you have so many abilities that either rely on a kill shot or rely on someone else having shot the target before, that your Reaper is probably not going to be the one shredding targets in your mission. So having more Shredder in your team is always good, but I'm not sure if the Reaper is the right choice. It kind of depends on your squad composition, and if you desperately need it, sure, pick it up. It's not a bad choice, for Rifle Reaper at least, but I also think it's not my first pickup here. Remote Start, if you really miss that, hey, it is still there. It is one charge per mission, so you can only use it once, but it still does the whole thing with double the explosion radius, double the damage. If you pick it up, you probably realize, oh, I thought that was better in the base game. And it's probably better in the base game because you have unlimited charges and not just one use. What else do we have? Soul Harvest is really a strong pickup in order to get your 100% crit chance for Death Dealer, allowing you to stack up some additional passive crit gain. Then Sting here, shot guaranteed to remain in shadow, and some additional functionality here is being that you holo target the target for other enemies, for other squad mates. So that's nice to see. Then we have some perks, some other perks that allow you to get to the 100% crit chance, right? Predator, for example, bonus crit to flanked units. That's exactly the 15% we kind of needed to get to the 100 for Death Dealer. Open Fire is kind of okay also on that regard, 10% crit against targets that are at full health. That being said, you wanna shoot targets that have been injured this turn most of the time, so it's not ideal, it's still a solid pickup. Impulse can be really strong because you probably, especially on a knife build, you're moving often and then throwing your knives, so 3-10 aim and crit chance, super good. And then we come to, for example, yeah, what I mentioned before, CDG, coup de grace, bonus hit damage and crit chance against stunned or disoriented enemies. If you have a grenade build and you disorient your own targets, that's fantastic. If you're running with a support grenadier who disorients targets for you, that's also really a good pickup for any other build, really. Center Mass might be a nice pickup then in combination with pistol skills, because the bonus damage from this also applies to your pistols. Obviously, when using guns means it is for rifle build, not for knife, but rifle plus pistols, you get the plus one damage from Center Mass, plus two damage from Blood Trail. That really brings pistols to very respectable damage numbers. Finally, one special mention needs to be given to Rapid Reaction. It's like the only real Overwatch perk here, in a way, although I think I saw Ever Vigilant in the base row, which you might give for a nice combination. So what you can do with Rapid Reaction. If you go onto Overwatch the turn before you lose Shadow Concealment, right? Before you drop out of Shadow, then on at the start of your next turn, you drop out of Shadow. At that moment, when you drop out of Shadow, your Overwatch will still be active. So what you can do, if you are in vision of an unactivated pot, you drop out of Shadow, they see you, they activate, you get your up to 3 reaction shots with, thanks to Rapid Reaction, and then your turn officially starts with you having 2 free actions. That's a really strong opener against groups. And I wouldn't discard this easily. That's really one of the strongest ways of activating pots. You get 3 free shots, and then it's XCOM's turn, and you can do with the enemy whatever you want. So definitely, I think if you see Rapid Reaction there and you have some decent aim to go with a rifle build, slap that hair trigger on your weapon and see if you can get any other support to make your Overwatch better. You unfortunately can't get Cool Under Pressure to make them crit, unless I missed it somewhere. I didn't see it, no. But yeah, maybe even something like Concentration to avoid grazes. Vigilant allows you to set that up even easier. Heck, Open Fire, obviously, 10 aim. Well, crit is wasted, but 10 aim against targets at full health. Well, turns out if you activate enemies with Rapid Reaction, they probably are at full health. So I really like the Rapid Reaction approach of activating enemy groups, and I think that's one of the strongest things the Reaper can probably accomplish. So that's it for the Reaper guide. So one more video on Sparks and one more on Psyonix, and then I think we're done with the class series. Looking forward to reading your comments on this one, especially some of the open questions I had, and thanks for watching. See you next time.